and that's George Tenet. The only thing Tenet has is a Presidential Medal of Freedom that was draped over his head by George W. Bush, and that and about $3.45 will get him a latte grande at Starbucks. So Tenet, I think, is the likely person who will come forward, whether he's called to testify before the House Intelligence Committee. Another telling thing will be this House Intelligence Committee probe they're talking about, and maybe one in the Senate as well, the Senate Intelligence Committee, will it be done in camera, in classified session, or will it be done in public? If it's done behind closed doors without the public being in on the hearings, I think it's an indication that this program was much worse than what has been advertised. I noticed Cheney sending his daughter, Liz Cheney, out to say, oh, well, this was just targeting Al-Qaeda members. Well, if that's the case, what's the big problem here? It's obviously it's much more than that, and they're trying to do, the Cheneys are trying to do damage control here. But here's something very interesting about how it was operated, this group was operating out of the Pentagon. I know for a fact that ex-Delta Force contractors who were working for JSOC were sent into Iran.
Wait a minute. Let me stop you. Yeah. I don't mean to interrupt, but that's important. You're saying this is above Delta Force, that they're actually sheep-dipping them out of Delta. So these are men, quote, formerly associated with Special Forces.
Right, and some of these guys actually went to work at the CIA in something called the Special Activities Division. Everybody might remember Mike Spann, the guy who was killed at Mazar-e Sharif when we first went into Afghanistan. He's the guy who found Lind, John Walker Lind, amongst those prisoners. He was killed. So SAD was involved in this from the beginning, but then the CIA said, hey, wait a minute, this is something we don't want any part of. They
backed
off.
It's above Delta. You were saying they were in Iran. Go ahead.
They were in Iran in one case, I know they were operating under journalistic cover. They went in as American journalists, but they were there to identify soft targets for assassinations and sabotage. This occurred in 2003, so this program was ongoing. Now we know that there were a number of airplane crashes in Iran. Some took out top officers in the Revolutionary Guards, the elite Iran military force. There was civilian airliners targeted, as well as a Russian-built plane that went down carrying a number of Ukrainian and Russian engineers to the city of Isfahan. Now, Isfahan was the center for Iran's uranium enrichment program. We may have Cheney's fingerprints on a number of airplane crashes in Iran that were sabotage.
Incredible info, WayneMadsenReport.com. Our sites are Infowars.com, PrisonPlanet.tv, JonesReport.com, TruthNews.us. Just unbelievably important information from Wayne Madsen. He'll be with us into the next segment. I want to also get his take on eugenicists in the federal government as well before he leaves us. And any other big breaking news he's working on, because you're hearing a lot of this here first. If you're a new listener and you heard me say that the United States government's funding Al-Qaeda inside Iran, that's not a joke. Believe me, I wish it was. That's how two-faced all this is. None of it means anything. The Wahhabis were created by British intelligence. They work for the West. They go in and overthrow any Muslim nation or Middle Eastern nation the globalists don't control. And Wayne Madsen is staying with us into the next segment to talk about some other issues as well. But I've noticed we've seen Newt Gingrich running around in the news saying we need to run black ops and sabotage inside Iran. And we were talking during the break, Wayne, you're saying that's him hiding in plain view because one of his chief aides has been involved in this special operation.
Worked for Douglas Feith in the Office of Special Plans, and Ludi was very much part of this special unit that was operating basically under the orders of Dick Cheney. I would also point out that Donald Rumsfeld's military aide, a guy named Stephen Bucci, was in the chain of command for these JSOC ex-Delta Force guys who were probing soft targets in Iran. Rumsfeld and Cheney are neighbors over in St. Michael's on the Eastern Shore in Maryland. They're very good friends. They're soulmates, you know, very core. And I think the one name that has not come up with this is Rumsfeld. Rumsfeld, his personnel, whether contractor or active duty special ops, who were carrying out these attacks in concert with these Kadan people. Kadan is a Hebrew word for bayonet. As I said, specialize in assassinations and kidnappings and sabotage, quite active in Iran's nuclear facility in Pakistani, that of Pakistan as well. They were active in Pakistan against the Pakistan nuclear program. I would also point out that Eric Holder, it's very interesting what he's saying. He says, well, he's considering a special prosecutor to look at torture. I believe that's a diversion because as bad as torture is, it comes nowhere to political assassinations. Torture victims, of course, may be scarred psychologically for life, but people who are assassinated, that's it, they're gone.
Plus, this shows the chain of command. We didn't have you potted up at first. Give us the name again of the Genrich Minion and how he was involved.
Well, William Ludi worked under this Office of Special Plans. He worked for Douglas Feith. Now, there were Israeli Mossad and IDF officers coming into the Pentagon during this time, going to see Feith, and Ludi were not signing in. There was no record of them entering or leaving the Pentagon. This was in complete violation of established Pentagon security procedures. I know from talking to people who worked there, they were shocked. Even longtime civil service secretaries were shocked at the ease of access these Israelis had.
Is Feith Mossad like the White House Chief of Staff?
Well, Feith's father was a longtime official of the Zionist Organization of America. You could just say, what are they? Obviously, they're an Israeli front, whether they're a Mossad front, who knows, but they're definitely part of this.
Well,
this
my issue is love Israel or hate Israel. Israeli spies shouldn't be above our own generals in this special office set up by Bush, and they're like gods who show up and go past all the security and then brag in the U.S. news that they've got hit teams here pulling triggers. I mean, this is ridiculous.
Well, that's right. And I would also note that we're told that this operation began after 9/11, but there's an indication that it may actually have been active prior to 9/11 because there was an assassination carried out against the father of Iran's missiles, a man named Ali Mahmoudi Mehman, who was assassinated by an explosion at a laboratory south of Tehran on, get the date, July 11th, 2001, 2 months prior to 9/11. So if that was this joint JSOC Mossad team, in those days it may have included the CIA. What role did that particular group play in what happened 2 months later?
Well, how are they operating in Iran? I mean, they're doing this through operatives they've got working for them, right?
They have a number of spies, agents, even ethnic Persians were spying for these individuals, as well as the Mojahedini Khalq, the terrorist group that was Richard Pearl's favorite organization.
The Prince of Darkness, Richard Pearl. Unbelievable. Stay there, Wayne. Let's get into any other important facets of this. Then I got a few other important issues I want to bring up to you as well. We got under Michael Kaufman, a climatologist, biologist, expert in forest ecology, is what one of his PhDs is in. He'll be joining us to talk about the global carbon tax, the eugenicist, in light of the new textbooks. It's not textbook. It's now multiple governmental-level textbooks. This is post-PhD level master planning. And he's put out a statement about it saying it's a textbook. Well, what's wrong with the textbook discussing how we need to poison you and sterilize you? Wayne Madsen, though, finishing up, I really appreciate you coming on with us. Other breaking news in and around this. I mean, I've really become to respect the amount of inside info. And, you know, if you don't break a story, you always then break huge new facets to it that no matter how wild it sounds, always ties in later and is vindicated. But so much of what you talked about these special hit teams, was really already hidden in plain view. My question to you is, and then anything else you've got to add, is why is it now breaking? Why is it now coming out? Because a few people talked about how the CIA was caught lying. Is the CIA trying to cover its butt? What's going on here?
Well, I think Leon Panetta, when he after he arrived at the CIA, was being briefed on some things and probably asked a couple of questions about this particular program. And when he realized how explosive this, no pun intended, could be, he said, well, let's get out from under this. Well, I'm going to cancel our residual involvement in this particular program before this thing. Because I think we know what the all the math here in Washington for a scandal.